Right, lads? One of the newest diesels to be built, the Class 17. Quite a fascinating design.
Yes.
Very intriguing.
We're all murmuring words of agreement. Lovely design.
Hello. In case some of you are wondering, that's me when I was first built. My name is Derek. I'm a Clayton Class 17 diesel built by British Railways. We were built with two engines, a centre clap, and low bonnet to increase versatility to the crew. There were 117 of us built between 1962 and 1965. I don't know all of them, but I had a brother who I was close with. His name was Alan. We worked together just north of Scotland, carrying small duties like stopping passenger and small goods trains. We had the best intentions to work hard, but we didn't live up to expectations. Every class member had suffered from poor performance issues and tend to overheat. We tried our best, but kept having trouble with our engines. We were considered as bad as the Metrovex before us. The diesels would talk rudely to us whenever they passed us. My brother Alan and I still continue to work on the line we worked. Until 1968, the manager came to see us.
I'm sorry, you two. It is with a heavy heart to say we have no choice but to retire you both from service.
What?
To put it short, we can't afford to keep repairing you with all the breakdowns you've been having.
But sir, we don't mean the breakdown.
We try our best no matter what.
Don't get me wrong. You two have done a lot for this line, and we thank you for it. Which is why we don't want to see you get scrapped.
What do you mean?
I mean we were able to find you each a new home. However, you will be separated from each other.
We understand, sir.
Right. Alan, you've been brought to work at the Ribble Cement Works. Derek, you will go on trial on an island called Sodor, starting with China Clay Trains.
Sodor?
Yes. It's past Barrow and Furnace. Its railway is operated mostly by steam engines, with a few diesels. I'm sure you'll find that place to be home.
I hope so. It sounds nice, but what if they feel threatened by me?
You'll be fine. Now, you both will leave tomorrow. I want to wish you both a safe journey to your new homes. Best of luck. We're grateful for all you've done for this line.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
That night at the sheds were quiet. It was the last time I would ever see my brother.
Derek?
Yes, Alan?
I wish you the best of luck on Sodor. I know they'll be lucky to have you.
Thank you. I wish you luck at the cement works. Who knows? Maybe you'll go back to the mainline trains.
That would be nice.
I will miss you, though.
I'll miss you, too. I'm sure we'll see each other again.
Promise?
Promise.
Next day, we both left for our new home. I didn't have any problems as I crossed the bridge to the Northwestern Railway. I've never seen so many steam engines before. Some of them looked at me funny, while others would just whoosh me with long trains. Everything was fine until I reached a very large hill. As I began to climb it, I heard my engines making noise. My wheel slipped on the rails, and then dark smoke came from my engine. I wasn't going anywhere for a while. A little while later, another engine came to help me. To my surprise, it was a Metrovex Class 28. I never would have expected to meet one on an island mostly run by steam. He greeted me.
Hello there. My name is Boko. You must be the new diesel the Fuck Controller mentioned.
Yes, my name is Derek. I'm sorry to burden you. I have teething troubles.
Oh, I completely understand. I had the same issues before coming to Sodor.
Really? How is that possible?
I'll tell you on the way to the works. We're both blocking the line at the moment.
Oh, yes, of course. So I was brought to Croven's Gate, and Boko told me about how he came to Sodor, and that the Fat Controller fixed his teething problems. I was amazed. If a diesel like him could be repaired so well, maybe I could too. Unfortunately, the news about me and my teething troubles soon spread. The next day, I left the works and arrived at the China clay pit, where there were two yellow tank engines who looked exactly alike. I was nervous, but tried to make a good first impression. Hello, I'm Derek. Nice to meet you.
You're the new Diesel, right?
Yes.
Is it true you have a toothache?
I beg your pardon?
We were told you have a toothache. Do you need to see a dentist? How many of your teeth ache? Does your driver brush your teeth?
Oh, no. It's not toothache. It's teething problems. It's what happens when my engine overheats. It happens a lot.
Sorry, Derek.
It's no problem. Now, what do you say we take this train already? There was a long train next to them that was needed at the docks, so I chose to push from behind and have the two pull in front. At first it went well, but then we came to a hill. I started to struggle and the engines would cross. My engine was overheating again and I stopped while black smoke plummeted from my exhaust. The two tank engines then had to pull me and the train to the docks. A fitter was there to patch me up since there was no engine to bring me to the works. So I made my way to Croven's Gate, thinking about what a poor first impression I made, until I heard some whistling that sounded frantic. There in front of me was a small green tank engine shouting for help. I saw him past, and saw how scared he was. So I talked to my driver, and we raced after him.
Help! Help! Help!
It wasn't too far, but my engine was overheating as we chased after him. Eventually we caught up, and even passed him. We were able to change onto his line and buffer up to him together. Together, we braked as hard as we could and stopped at the next station. No one was hurt, but with a loud bang, my engine coughed, sputtered, and broke down. I felt embarrassed until the green engine spoke.
Oh, thank you for saving me.
Oh, it's no problem. What happened?
The trucks pushed me down the hill and I lost control.
Does that happen often?
Very often. I'm sorry about your engine.
It's alright. I was heading to the works anyway. At least, I was.
I can take you there. I'm heading past Croven's Gate. It's the least I can do after you helped me.
Thank you. Sorry, I didn't catch your name.
I'm Percy.
I'm Derek. Nice to meet you. Percy took me to the works so I can be repaired. When I got there, the fat controller was waiting for me.
Hello, Derek. How are you feeling?
A little hot, sir, but a bit embarrassed.
And why's that?
I wanted to make a good first impression, but instead I had two breakdowns and had to bother your engines to help me.
It's all right, Derek. It's not your fault. Your design isn't very reliable. I know you want to work hard and prove yourself. I also heard you saved one of my engines from having a nasty accident, and I'm proud of you. That's why I know you'll be a credit to my railway.
What do you mean?
Derek, I've known about the struggles your class has, performance issues and whatnot. You're not the first engine to come here and have those problems. The other diesel you met, Boko, had teething troubles too, but the men at these works were able to fix them. Imagine what they can do for you.
Sir, does that mean...
Indeed it does. Once you've been repaired and overhauled, you will be a member of my railway deck.
Thank you, sir. This is the best thing that's ever happened to me. So I went through an extensive overhaul and came out of the works feeling much better. It took a while for the engines to get used to me, but those two tank engines I mentioned put in a good word. Nowadays I handle goods and passenger trains all over the island, mostly helping on the Normandy branch with Arthur pulling fish trains. My engine still tends to overheat, but not as much as it did before. Although the rest of my class was scrapped, my brother Alan is the only other brother I know that made it into preservation. He's happy with his new life, and I'm happy for him. I do wish I could see him again. Maybe someday.
Don't be afraid of your freedom!
I'm free to do what I want any old time. I said I'm free to do what I want any old time.
Time.